Everyone has condemned not just this attack, but every attack that occurs in the name of Islam. And anyone who keeps saying that we need to hear the moderate voice of Islam, why aren't Muslims denouncing these violent attacks, doesn't own Google.
Yeah, I know. They're all over the place, just crawling out of the woodwork with condemnation. Gee, I saw Mahmoud Abbas, that great statesman that Barack Obama has cited as a great statesman, marching at the French rally. Yeah, it's a wonderful thing. Okay, before we get to our next guest, I just want to hear from you. Is President Obama handling Islamic terror properly? Go to Newsmax.com/polls and vote now. Newsmax.com/polls. All right, Dan Gainor, Vice President of Business and Culture for the Media Research Center, is with us. Hey, Dan.
Hey, how are you doing?
I'm doing well. You wrote a piece, I think this one I saw at FoxNews.com, talking about the media and how the media needs to stop covering for murderous Muslims, as you put it. And that was what just that opening soundbite was one example.
Well, I mean, you could find a whole bunch of examples in the major media. 24 hours before this all happened, we had the beginnings of the Zokhar Tsarnaev trial, the Boston bomber. And ABC, CBS, and NBC, they covered the trial. They had no mention of the fact that he's Muslim and that the attacks were linked to radical Islam. No mention on all three networks. So I mean, that then 24 hours later, we get an attack in France. We've had an attack in France. We've had two in Canada, an attack in Australia, had a hatchet attack in New York. We understand this is going on. We know there are countless examples of radical Islam going around the world, and the media don't want to tell us. And Boko
right.
Haram.
And Dan, I could put. Go ahead. I'm sorry.
I was going to say Boko Haram killed 2,000 people the other day. 2,000. NBC still didn't cover. They covered it on their website. But you know, what are 2,000 people murdered by murderous Muslims? What does that mean? Nothing, we're not going to cover that.
Well, you just named a huge outrage. I mean, this Boko Haram nonsense. I remember when Michelle Obama misrepresented them when the girls were kidnapped. She did a whole video, I think it was a Saturday presidential address, where she just talked about how Boko Haram doesn't want girls to get educated. You know, doesn't want girls to have an education when, of course, Boko Haram had a history, even at that point, of slaughtering thousands of people. And they did it again, as you pointed out. But, you know, take it to this one. I was in Brooklyn over the weekend in New York. My mom still lives there. And she lives a block away, as it turns out, from one of the police officers that was assassinated in Brooklyn a month ago. And I saw the house. I mean, I couldn't believe that she lived so close. I had no idea. My point is, this executioner of those two police officers had Muslim influence, had Muslim background, and we had one guest, Andrew Bostom, who connected it to a fatwa that was put out against police officers, and we saw not only that assassination, but other police attacked around the world. But again, the media doesn't want to hear that.
Yeah, instead, what they do, they will highlight the example, and it was a brave example of the French police officer happened to be Muslim. No one, I mean, I feel silly that you have to bring this up, but no one is saying that all Muslims are terrorists. But when you look at the facts, the Washington Post had a real good analysis that ran, I think it was last year, but talking about how nations like Egypt and many of the Muslim nations believe either in a majority or significant minority that people who leave Islam should be killed. This is the nature. Yep. You know, no one wants to talk about this. This is what radical Islam is.
No, you're right. It's also like Bill Maher says: if they were beheading people in at the Vatican, we'd hear about it. But when people are beheaded in Mecca, as according to Bill Maher, you don't hear anything. Also, you point out in your piece when Tom Clancy's book, The Sum of All Fears, became a movie, the terrorists weren't who they were in the book anymore.
Yeah, entertainment media tries desperately to placate lefty, subject groups, Arab Americans, gays, whatever. So they don't. So if you write a book and you include Muslim terrorists, by the time it hits the movies, it's Russians. They're bad guy Russians. They've got funny accents. We can target them. it's just so PC. We are PCing ourselves to death.
Yeah, and you really wonder how that's possible, because it all started after 9/11, once the dust settled, and you really have to wonder how that is possible. But it has happened. Hey, Dan, keep up the good work. Thanks for joining us. Appreciate it, sir.
Thank you very much, Steve. Talk to you soon.
You too. All right, folks. Up next, associate editor for HotAir.com, Noah Rothman will be here. We'll continue to take a look at the French unity rally, the aftermath, the excuses now by the White House. It's all coming up. Don't go away.